Hello everyone, in this video we have one circle and one quarter circle, and then O is given center of the quarter circle, and these are given as tangent points. And the question is, what is the ratio of the length of AC to the length of OD? Okay, first of all, let's call the length of the AC x, and this side I want to represent with y, and let's call center of the yellow circle k. After that, if you connect these 3 points, this line must be linear because of tangency, right? Let's remind you, if you have a two circle which is tangent to each other like this, let's call here tangent point, and after that let's call O1, O2. Of course O1 and O2 are center points, so if you connect these 3 points, this line must be linear because of tangency. Okay. Therefore, the line OKE must be linear because of tangency. Right. And then let's draw one perpendicular like this. Notice that here is tangent points, so this angle must be equal 90 degrees. Likewise, if you draw one more perpendicular, here this angle is also 90 degrees. Right? Right. Then I want to represent radius of the yellow circle with lowercase r, so these are also r unit, right? And let's call radius of the quartz circle uppercase R. And then if you focus on triangle ODK, hypotenuse must be equal uppercase R minus lowercase r, right? Okay, let me clear here. After that, if you focus on triangle ODK, for this triangle, if you apply Pythagorean theorem, let's write here, for triangle DOK, if you apply Pythagorean theorem, y squared plus r squared equal uppercase r minus lowercase r whole squared. Right? This is the first equation. Now, if you draw a perpendicular line onto the line OA, like this, and let's call here point L, if you notice that, we get rectangle, right? Therefore, OLKD is a rectangle. So, if here is lowercase r, that means here must be equal lowercase r unit. And we know that radius of the quad circle is uppercase r, so uppercase r minus lowercase r left here. Right? Okay. Next step, if we connect point A and point K like this, notice that if it is y, this length must be equal y unit. Okay. After that, if you focus on triangle KLA and triangle KCA, these two triangles have common hypotenuse, right? So let's write here triangle KLA and triangle KCA have common hypotenuse, right? Okay. Therefore, if you apply Pythagorean theorem for these two triangles, so uppercase R minus lowercase r whole squared plus y squared is equal to the square of the length of AK. Right? Okay. Now, if you focus on the other triangle, x squared plus r squared is equal to the square of the length of AK. Okay, if you notice that right-hand side of the equation are equal, that means left-hand side of the equation must be equal, right? Therefore, if we equalize these two equations, uppercase r minus lowercase r whole squared plus y squared equal x squared plus lowercase r squared. You know that from the first equation, uppercase r minus lowercase r whole squared equal y squared plus lowercase r squared. Right? So, if you plug in this value to the equation, so y squared plus lowercase r squared plus y squared equal x squared plus lowercase r squared. Therefore, these are cancelled out, so x squared equal to y squared, right? And then, if you square root both sides of the equation, therefore, x equal y root 2. That means the ratio of x and y is equal to the square root of 2. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.